So I'm in the Sangre De Cristo mountain range, ready to begin my hike to base camp in the South Colony Lakes Basin. I'm going to try to attempt Crestone Peak and Crestone Needle tomorrow, and maybe throw on Humboldt. We'll see. But it's looking absolutely beautiful today. Let me see if I can show you. Weather's a little sketchy, but tomorrow I heard it was going to clear up. And yeah, I'm really excited for this because the Crestones are known as one of the harder 14ers, so it'll be pretty exciting to see. I'm just super pumped. Also, my friends Jenna and Sal came to visit me yesterday, and I feel energized now. So I'm super excited to make this video and show everyone what went down. So see you on the trail.
Ooh, not looking good. I'm hearing some lightning and some thunder. So I'm a total idiot. I thought I packed my rain jacket near the top, but I think when I was packing, I packed it near the middle bottom because it's a heavier item. And then it started to pour. And I was like, oh, I'll get it out. And then I got soaked because I had to take every freaking thing out of my backpack. So don't be like Kyle. Be smarter than that. And now all my crap's wet. So let's hope it dries tomorrow. So I guess now's a good time to answer a question I get a lot from my friends is, do I listen to music? Short answer, no, I don't. Mainly because a lot of the drives I do are 2 hours or more, and I get through all my favorite playlists on the drive, so I don't really want to listen to it twice. And then also, since I do a lot of day hikes, I like to stay focused when I'm doing 14ers. A lot of the easy ones you don't really have to, but I think I'm also just lazy to pull it out. So it's been an hour and I've gone 2.4 miles. So started to pour again. I think my backpack got soaked again because it's really hard to fit this over the freaking pack because it sticks out so much. But otherwise, I like the rain. I just hope my crap's not wet because that would suck.
Yeah, not ideal. And it's hailing too. So, this is probably the most it's ever rained for me, being from Phoenix.
So, it's been nonstop pouring for the last half hour. I guess this is why I came to Colorado. It's finally starting to die down. The thunder's kind of scary. There's been some lightning strikes pretty close by. Like the creek over here is flooding a little bit. But it's really pretty out. I'm not sure whether to be concerned or delighted or both. I'm absolutely soaked though, like freaking legs, like look at that. I am praying that the stuff in my pack is dry. And look at this, I gotta like tiptoe around all this crap.
Setting up this camp. camp here was awful. I hated it. So now I'm just chilling out, eating some peanut butter, and I'm like really hungry, and I want to use my freeze-dried food, but like I'm scared to get wet. So anyways, that's what's happened so far. Alright, so things finally calmed down. It's been raining so freaking much. I think this is the most rain, like, if you were to combine this in my life some amount of rain, this would tie it, probably. Maybe even be more. I'm not sure. But here's the current setup. Yeah, we got wet items here. Like, they were so soaked. It's ridiculous. We've got other wet items, you know, well, that's like a rain jacket, because there was some rain getting through. I'm not even sure how. That's drying because it's hanging. This is hanging and drying. Dry section back there. And then socks on each corner here to dry. And I got my food, and now I'm just going to play some Game Boy because I brought it. It's a luxury. And you might be wondering which game. Here you go. Pokemon. That's right. Fire Red. Brings me back to elementary school. Anyway, I'm going to eat, play some of that, chill, and pray that the weather is clear tomorrow and that the weathermen did not lie. That's it for now. See you tomorrow morning. Okay, it's like 7:30 in the morning. Last night was my worst camping experience I've ever had. My tent flooded. It was so windy that the tent frame was folding in on itself and kept smacking me in my head, so didn't get much sleep last night. But here we are, 29 minutes later, and I'm about to get to Broken Hand Pass. So that's pretty cool, which is that way. And this place is pretty gnarly. I mean, the basin itself, not as cool as Chicago Basin, but the mountains are great. I mean, look at this crap. Like, it's pretty sweet, you know?
That was gnarly. Oh my gosh. Okay. Ooh-wee. I just summited Crestone Needle. I'm pretty excited. I kind of sound monotone right now, but I'm kind of beat. I was going to add on Crestone Peak as well, which is right there. But I kind of have an upset stomach and I'm really tired. I think it was that Forever Young mac and cheese I had last night. I don't like it.
Yeah, no, it was insane. Jeez, like, they said this was class 3, but I'm not feeling it. I think it was more class 4 than anything. Because Long's was class 3, and it was, like, a piece of cake compared to this, actually. But this is considered one of the harder 14ers, probably top 5 hardest. And I just summited, so that's half the battle. Now I have to down climb all that crap, and that is not going to be fun. I'm going to be very slow. I'm not going to really film on the way down, so I can make it back to the basin, and then I will probably pack up my gear and head out. I was going to stay up here till Tuesday, but after the night I had last night with the rain and wind, I'm not sticking around for another night. I really just want to do needle today because, one, it was closer, and two, it just looked cooler, to be honest. And normally mountains have names like Sunlight Peak, like Peak at the End, or, you know, Mountain, or whatever. But this is a needle. That's kind of cool. So anyway, I'm going to chill up here for a little longer and then see if I can head down and meet up with a group that was going down that I passed, so I can see where their handhold and footholds are. So more to come later. I was minding my own business eating my peanut butter here, and then I turned around and this guy was watching me. Kind of weird. I don't know what he wants. Do you want some peanut butter? So, in case any of you guys ever want to climb this, that's nearly vertical, by the way. The phone never does it justice. If you get to this point, it's called dihedral. Up that way is class 4, which is like pretty much vertical. And if you want to do the standard route like I did, you have to cross this here. It's probably like 8 feet deep. It's hard to tell, but like, you obviously can't jump across it, or you're gonna go tumbling down this valley here. This gully, sorry. So what I did, the first time I think I effed up quite a bit, but I don't know, maybe I did the same thing, but it's tricky. It's really tricky. So when I was coming down, I went across this way, down, up to where I am now. And I recommend doing that if you go up there as well. Because you're coming down from there, so come up all the way up here. There's like some easy climbing down that way. Get up there, and this is where it gets a little tricky because there's like not good footholds, not good handholds. But you go this way and then up. All right, so this is the end of my adventure in the South Colony Lakes Basin. It was a really good one. I didn't get as many 14ers as I wanted. I wanted to do Crestone Peak and then Humboldt here, if I could manage, but needle by itself, pretty gnarly. Very cool. Probably my favorite 14er now. Sunlight and Longs used to be, but they really don't compare to this one. This one was just another level. Longs is supposed to be class 3, and Sunlight's supposed to be class 4, I think just because of the Leap of Faith section, but honestly, if Sunlight's class 4 and Longs is class 3, then this must be like, it felt like class 4, maybe low class 5 in some sections, because Longs and Sunlight don't even compare to the climbing I had to do for this one. Then again, a lot of the routes on these harder mountains are more of a choose-your-own-adventure sort of thing, but anyways, overall, really nice mountain. I'd give it a 10 out of 10 for the mountain, but I'd give it a overall trip like 6 out of 10 just because yesterday was really miserable and last night sucked hard. But there's not going to be much else on the way back. You guys already saw footage on the way up, so it'll be the same stuff. And I'll just do a little quick pano and call it a day. And get some milkshake. Get a milkshake afterwards. Yeah, I want a milkshake. Anyway, let's see. We've got 13ers over there. I think that's the Crestone Needle right there. Because I went up there and then way up there. Whatever. This whole mirrored angle thing is weird, but yeah. And then Humboldt's right there. So anyway, super fun. Top 5 14ers in terms of difficulty, complete. And time to go. Bye!